world it was in my childhood day. Oh Lord, many long years ago.
Like the little boy that lived in that house where they bulldozed and built that thing, used to come over here and come over to our house, and he was wanted to know if I had a Nintendo. That's when those all came out. I said, no, I don't have one. He said, did you have one when you were a little girl? I said, Colin, I didn't have a TV. He said, you kidding? I said, they hadn't been invented.
Mrs. Woods, would you mind giving us your age?
I said, if I live till Easter Sunday, it's never been on Easter Sunday, I don't think. But if I live till then, that'll be the 20th of April, and I will be 96.
Awesome, yeah. Awesome. And how long were you and your husband married?
We got married in March of 1941. Mm-hmm. And we would have been married exactly 70 years from 41 to 2011 would have been
70 years.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And he died in January of 11.
Really?
Yeah. Mm. So, but he got along pretty good. Died in his sleep, and that's the way he wanted to go.
Tell us about your father being a doctor, country doctor. How did he meet his patients, and how was he paid?
My dad graduated from the University of Maryland in 1910. Mm-hmm. And I assume there was not much medicine to learn in 1910. And all of them just about were country doctors unless they had a hospital, you know, worked in a hospital, and there weren't that many hospitals either. Mm-hmm. But anyway, his father had been a doctor, and he died when my dad was just 9 years old. So, but he had an older sister and an older brother. And so he practiced medicine in little, you know, country towns. He was from Gadsden County, mm-hmm. and he practiced some there. And then he moved to Jackson County. Mm-hmm. And that's where he met my mother. But by that time, he was 39 years old. And my grandmother was, he was looking after my grandmother. Mm-hmm. And so she lived with us until she died. But anyway, he moved to Jackson County to a little town, Bascom is about disappeared now, but it was alive. Back then, those little towns, they had like a cotton gin, mm-hmm. and a sawmill, mm-hmm. and a barrel factory, and you know,
I've been through Basque, and I've been through there once.
But anyway, that's where he was. And my mother as a teacher, but you could start teaching when you got out of high school, mm-hmm. if you took a test, you know. So she taught, had been teaching school for a long time with that, and then she would start taking courses, extension courses and stuff. And she had been down state teaching, I guess, and then came back up where that was her home in Bascom. And that's where my dad met her. She was 28 at the time. So they got married, and then here I came. And Mom wanted to have her kids before she got to be 30. So she had both of us before she was 30. My brother is just 14 months younger than I am. But anyway, my dad went down too. He got a job at the state prison farm, and he went down there. But that didn't last too long, about a couple of years. And then he moved back to Jackson County, and this time it was in Malone. So that's what I remember, because I was about 4 years old. My brother was 3, I guess. So we came up there, and everything was nice and fine until the Depression hit. I remember we seemed like we were getting along pretty good. We had cars had been invented, you know. We had gotten all the way up to a Ford, an A model or something, and then I remember we had an old Buick. It was a Dodge. They had it. Oh gosh, I can see it now. It was long, long old thing. Of course, gas didn't cost anything much. But anyway, the Depression came when I was, it was in 29. I was 11 years old. So things changed pretty quickly. The people didn't have any money, but they had a lot of cows and pigs and chickens and vegetables and hay and corn and that sort of stuff. Mm-hmm. So that's what he ended up having, but that didn't pay gasoline bill or electricity. Well, we didn't have electricity until the TVA came along. Mm-hmm. And so he had to pay electricity bill too. I started driving when I was about 12 or 13.
Did you tell me that you would drive your father around?
Oh, yeah.
When he was, as a doctor, when he was going to visit his patients?
A lot of the times I would, and sometimes after I got up and was in college, when I was home in the summertime, you know, and besides that, when they needed the doctor, they came and got him. There were no telephones. They came and got him and told him to get there. You know, whether it was early in the morning or late at night or whatever. And so a lot of times somebody would come and want him to go somewhere, and I'd be coming in off of a date or something, and I'd say, well, he's not here right now, but I'll wait. And so then I'd just go take him, you know.
And you didn't have a driver's license or anything?
You didn't have to have one. You get your driver's license until I was about 21. That's when you had to have one. Uh-huh. And so I'd been driving all that time. So anyway, a lot of times when we were little, a lot of times there was not much to do. So my mom would say if my dad was going somewhere that somebody didn't have something that was contagious, you know, she'd put us in the car and we'd sing all the way there and back, and he'd see the patient and get back.
Awesome.
So it's a different life now than it was back then, but I don't know any different. You know, you just live what you got.
Well, life has been good to you, I can see that.
Well, it has, and I've been good to I've you. Enjoyed it.
Yes.
I can't, even when things weren't too good, I didn't know the difference. We did something.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted a pony so bad when I was little, and somebody had one and gave it. Didn't give it to him, paid him. Uh-huh. And I just lived on that little old thing for about 3 or 4 years till she died.
Oh,
so, but I can't complain. I can't complain about being poor or being rich. Never been either one, as far as I'm concerned. Just been able to live.
Maybe that's the secret to life, just being able to live.
That's right. Well, my first job, I made $60 a month. Mm-hmm. And that was pretty good because my mom only made $30 a month.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes during the Depression, she'd get a IOU
because
they didn't have any money.
Mm-hmm.
So the man that had the rural route, you know, he used to deliver mail on a rural route.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so the man that had this rural route, evidently he had more money than my dad, because he had a radio. He got one first. And so we were in a Model T. And we were going out there, and it was on a dirt road, and it was like sandy. And their little, those Model T's had those little tiny tires. And it was stuck in there, and so my mom was gonna help push out of the sand, and it jumped and she fell in the sand. But anyway, we were gonna go hear that radio. And so by the time we got there, I guess my parents heard the radio, but my brother had gone to sleep. So we missed the whole thing. So that's all I remember back going to hear the first radio. But I've got the old one of the old radios in yonder in my living room.